Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Marwa Abbas, Professor of Clinical Toxicology, Zagazig Faculty of Medicine and FAMR Fellow, Batch 2020. My project was about implementation of fork place-based assessment in Clinical Toxicology Master Degree Program. Formative assessment for postgraduate students is used by Forensic Medicine and Clinical Toxicology Department since 2010. It's designed to test only medical knowledge. So the annual plan for the department for the academic year 2019-2020 include an objective to use new clinical assessment methods that test postgraduate performance in clinical settings such as workplace-based assessment. To achieve such objective, a training package was developed including training on different tools for workplace-based assessment, how to design and use mini CX checklists, how to give constructive feedback, and self-reflection. A training workshop was conducted for 22 staff members and 5 postgraduate students on March 22. This training was followed by 2 consecutive hand-on training sessions on mini CX checklist of the American Board of Internal Medicine, adopted to include only history taking and physical assessment with a 9-point scale of rating and a box for assessor feedback and trainee response. Trainee satisfaction and comments were gathered to prepare a feedback report. Feedback report on the training process was presented to the department council, where the overall satisfaction rate of the trainees on the training conducted was over 90%, and majority of them find that this training increased their knowledge about tools for workplace-based assessment and their skills on using mini CX checklist and giving constructive feedback. The report also includes the following recommendation that was approved by the Department Council, where satisfactory performance of the postgraduate students on mini CX checklist is mandatory for them to be eligible for their summative exam. As most trainees find that using the current checklist is not easy, and it's difficult to make a clinical decision because most competences are integrated and not all competences described into components. So it's recommended to modify the currently used checklist and use alternative clinical assessment frameworks such as EBA. For developing EBA, 3 phases were conducted. First phase, EBA identification, where a focus group of the department review the literature and find 10 potential EBAs mapped on the 3 milestones for the MSSC program, where resident entry, chief resident, and finally the specialist. Then for EBA elaboration, a survey was designed including potential EBA that each EBA divided into its main components. Then for EBA validation, an orientation session was conducted for the department council members. Then the survey was distributed asking them to rate the importance of each EBA, each component, and the relation of each EBA to the milestone. Because of the big number of EBAs and its complexity, only 3 EBAs were having consensus, which are history taking and 2 bedside procedures, airway insertion and gastric lavage. It be concluded that EBA are essential means to translate clinical competences into observable and measurable clinical practices. But for proper EBA validation, it's recommended to increase the sample size, include wide range of stakeholders, and use alternative methods such as interview instead of survey. Lastly, I want to provide my great thanks to Professor Muhammad Hassanin, Assumina Fry Regional Institute faculty, for his kind and meticulous supervision and feedback. Thank you.